and Tsuyoi!
And we're back! An extra tale. So, me and Tsuyoi were discussing it, and we came to a realization on something. It's hard to talk about stuff when you're running around talking to everybody in like a dialogue-heavy game and having to stop every couple of seconds.
Indeed.
So, what we'll do is that like we'll kill sort of two birds with one stone. Now, use this opportunity to show you what it's like to gain levels and stuff in this game, you know, by throwing ourselves at this enemies. But I'll fill it in with like what I've been wanting to say the last episode, which I got like what, two sentences in of what I wanted to say.
Yes.
Okay. So for a quick recap. I'm just gonna talk about a certain servant to help build up to how someone else can be a comparable servant.
Is this probably Ado's favorite servant of all time? Oh, I put you in a tough spot there, Ado. That was a perfect way to warm up for a real battle. Gonna be a grand battle.
God dang, you did put me on the spot right there. Like, in the past, yes, she was my number one, absolute most favorite servant. But nowadays, yeah. you're basically asking me to choose between my favorite and my waifu. Like, you get what I mean by that?
Yes, I kind of do.
Like, I would have, you know. For me, like, Caster is just, like, one of my top most, Caster from this game, so extra Caster.
Oh, I got a perfect Ado! I did it! Yeah, and I won one battle! I should get a bonus for that, come on. It is my duty to wield a sword. You are to stay behind me, but I'm walking in front of you.
Yeah, well, when the spark's flying. Okay, so, be sure to mention to me whenever it says reading enemy data, because I'm sure, like, I'll somehow just not catch it in my ramblings. Okay, so, on to the servant who used to be my number one favorite servant. It is the assassin class servant, Jack the Ripper, who I personally like to refer to as Loli Rippa. Because of how they decided to present her, servant-wise.
Oh, I did it again.
Yeah. So, according to Fateverse, Jack the Ripper is just like some street orphan girl that went really mentally insane growing up on the mean streets of London.
One after the other, they come hyphen. When will they ever learn? Will they ever learn?
And the whole thing about the cutting up prostitutes was that she would approach them and like try to act like that they're her mom. They would shoo her away and she would go away. But due to the mental instability, she would later approach them and then just cut out their wombs and just kind of nuzzle it for a while. Trying to remember that warm, soft spot that she came from before she was born to this, like, harsh, cruel world.
How'd they explain the, doctor-like surgicalness? How she was, really good at surgery and stuff.
Apparently just something that came from practice. Or a mistake. Like, they never really addressed it too well of, where that whole, the doctoring thing came from.
Now nothing's spawning.
Oh, it'll spawn. You know, you just gotta give it a bit, make a full circle around the area. So...
can't fight Kabuterimon. Alright.
So let's talk about this servant. She's an assassin class, so that means that she gets the one skill that all assassins get. Presence concealment.
Being fucking invisible!
Yes, the capacity to hide one's presence as a servant is a common skill to the assassin class, proudly given to each and every one of them. And if you may recall, all skills have ranks associated with them.
So some are better at than others?
Yes. And for Loli Rippa...
I would assume it wouldn't be very good considering she just walked up to most of her victims. I mean, that's not very concealed if you ask me.
Oh, well, yes, it is concealed when you're able to walk up to your victims and you catch them completely unaware. Well, you never been surprised by someone just, like, walking up right behind you?
I suppose, but, I mean, she approached them to talk to them originally.
Oh, yeah, but then they were like, shoo, not daughter. And then she went up and visited them later.
Level 4. We've gained a level, but we need to put forth greater effort.
So, yeah, she actually has a rank of A+, in regards to her presence concealment.
Is that abnormally high for an SS? That seems kind of crazy.
The way it works is that ranks are quantifiable numbers, if you will.
I saw that.
When someone has a plus associated with a rank, that means that it has the ability to go beyond what a normal rank can qualify as. So, to give you an idea of just how good a rank of A+ is, it... this one time, she knocked out a guy by cutting off his arm and his jaw. She was able to keep him alive. And she was walking down the street, broad daylight, with her master leading the way. And no one ever noticed her. So, like, you know, just imagine, like, this little girl with a grown man, like, slung over her shoulder, just walking down the street in broad daylight.
Wouldn't they notice the guy?
No, because that's just apparently how good her presence concealment of A+ is. Yeah. So, you know, not bad for an assassin. You know, one which I hope that any assassin would be able to just, like, do that, wouldn't you think?
Well, I wouldn't expect any assassin to be able to carry something on top of them and people not see us floating. This is truly a magnificent fight. It's only natural to be in awe of me. But not. I played enough video games, this isn't very cool. Spoiled kids of today.
Yeah, so that's how good her presence concealment is of what she's able to do with that. Okay. Let's see if I can just find my notes here. Okay, so one of the most defining factors of a servant is their skill set. You know, like what they have as a heroic spirit, if you will. Things that make up their legends of what they're able to do. And she actually has 4 skills.
Wait, 4 skills? Okay.
Yep. Mm-hmm. Like, I remember how your Saber has...
migraines. It has terrible headaches.
She only has, like, about 3 skills. But, yeah, not Loli Rippa. Loli Rippa comes with 4 skills.
It's quality, not quantity.
Well, it certainly is quality when it comes to Loli Rippa. Alright, so her 4 skills are Murder of the Misty Night, Mental Pollution, Information Erasure, and Surgical Procedure. So you may be wondering, okay, well, what the heck is that all about?
I am, Ado, do go on.
Right. So, Murderer of the Misty Night is more or less the personification of the murders that she was able to commit.
She likes murder.
Let's see. I actually got like a definition right here. A skill associated with the servant's nature as a serial killer rather than as an assassin, which permits preemptive strikes against all opponents. However, unconditional success of the skill is possible only at night. And during daytime, it requires a successful luck check to not be hit by it.
Oh boy, D&D. roll for luck.
Oh yeah, if you'll remember...
I will remember.
All servants have alignments. You know, lawful, chaotic, all that kind of stuff. Yeah. So, what this essentially means is that she can always strike first on her opponent with this skill. And apparently this comes from the fact that all of Jack the Ripper's victims
weren't suspected.
Like, yeah, they wounds seem to indicate that they're always caught by surprise. And that's just translated into this skill. So this actually works really good with her, considering the way the presence concealment works. So although assassins are really good at like concealing their presence to be near nigh undetectable like she is, the moment they get ready to attack, that just goes away. So for like someone like Saber right there, if Jack like just walked up right behind her and got ready to attack, her presence concealment would just go away. And Saber would sense that, like, you know, oh, someone's gonna, like, attack me from behind with killer intent. And so, you know, she'd get ready and be able to counter. That's like...
critical?
Yeah, you can get criticals.
I thought that was one, okay.
Yeah, that's like one of the downfalls when it comes to assassins and presence concealment.
Right,
yeah,
it's only
pretty
good
much, yeah.
Not the last moment.
Yeah, just throwing right out the window the moment you get ready to attack. And that's get ready, that's not when you do the attack.
That's when you hold up your knife.
Yeah, that's when you hold up your knife. And so...
But she doesn't get that.
Well, actually, the thing is that due to murder of the Misty Knight, whenever she gets ready to attack, that means she's pretty much guaranteed to be able to strike first.
Right.
So even if, like, her presence concealment just totally goes away, it doesn't matter. Because she's pretty much guaranteed to preempt a strike on the opponent. So I guess that would be, like, a guaranteed backstab.
Well, just because she can attack first doesn't mean they can't turn around. It also doesn't mean they can't block.
Well, actually, it does.
Why not? They get first attack. She gets first attack, not block.
Yeah. You know, she gets first attack, which means like they aren't able to react. You know, preemptive strike.
It just says the preemptive strike lets her attack first, right?
Let's see.
I mean, the wording is important.
Permits preemptive strike against all opponents. However, unconditional success is possible only at night. So which means that if she attacks you at night, then it will be unconditionally successful for her.
Okay, it depends on what preemptive means then.
But are you not familiar with the...
I'm familiar but not with the definition specifically. But, okay, so she can get one good stab in.
Yeah, she can get one good stab in.
And then, you will definitely know that she's there.
Yes, you'll... Well, it's actually kind of funny you mention that about definitely know that she's there.
Well, you'll be stabbed, so...
Yeah. The thing is, she has another skill called Information Erasure.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. It has to do with the fact that no one knows who Jack the Ripper is, and, like, it was hard to find any information on the person. So, whenever she disengages from combat, all, like, evidence and all memories of her is just automatically removed from the area.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Wait, there's a rank to that, though, right?
Oh, actually, yes.
So then certain things could, like, get through that.
Yeah, she has a rank B in Information Erasure.
What skill would go against it?
I have no clue what would go against it.
Intelligence or something?
Well, here's effectively what happens. Whenever she goes away, you forget what she looks like and stuff like that. Like, you probably remember that you had a battle with her.
Oh, okay.
Right, like, you fought something, you just don't know what it was.
Oh, okay, so you keep at least that.
Right. And, like, even if there was, like, video cameras that recorded it...
It would be erased.
Like,
What, can they record that? I thought, are servants seenable by other people?
Yes.
Oh, right, of course they are.
Yeah. Like, any physical, trace slash presence of her would just be removed from the recording. I think the recording would still be there.
Does that include your wounds? Because that would be evidence that she was there.
Well, that's actually one of the things in it. That any evidence of, like, the battle, like, if there was, like, gashes in the concrete or wounds that you got during the fight, those stay.
Oh!
And the reason for that is that it allows you to deduce her identity from what little evidence has been left around like that. Now, if you can do that, then Information Erasure no longer has an effect on you.
Right, because you already figured it out in the battle.
Right. But, yeah, until then... She's basically this perfect ninja that at night can always get the first attack on you, and if that don't works out, she can just run away and there'd pretty much be no evidence of what went down, short of that you know something happened that hurt you.
So the best way to go up against her would be not to let her see your master. Or not to have the master anywhere near her, because she will get the first strike on you.
Yes. Or the first strike on the master. Honestly, assassins are really pretty much just built for attacking masters.
Right, but at least the servant of a master could detect it right when they're about to attack. You know, when they raise their knife. With her, no. So she could just kill masters.
Yeah. Just one-shot masters and one-shot certain servants, but I'll get into that in a bit.
Okay.
Okay, so her two other skills, mental pollution and surgical procedure. Well, mental pollution was that, remember how I said that she went mental growing up on the streets of London?
Indeed. Oh wow, I didn't even need to do my extra attack on her.
Yeah. Well, those horrible conditions she grew up in just psychologically damaged her beyond repair.
Oh, you mean that the stabbing people repeatedly didn't have anything to do with that?
It was, a symptom of the problem.
It didn't help.
Yeah, it didn't help. So, excuse me. Yeah. So what that means is it's actually kind of similar to your Saber's migraines.
Ah.
In that if anyone tries to use like a mind magic to mess with her, that like it has disadvantage.
Right. It's not as easy to do.
Right, and you can even increase the rank of her mental pollution. She starts at rank C, but can go higher. But in order to do that, you have to, like, abuse her at every given turn and stuff like that.
I was about to say, you gotta fuck her up.
Yes, essentially.
Oh, well, that's great. So she can attack her master, can't she?
Actually, she can. Every servant is capable of attacking their master. So, it's just a matter if they can do it before the master can command them to stop, or otherwise.
Okay, so if you're gonna go that route with her, you should probably command steal her immediately to never, ever betray or attack you.
Yeah.
Because she's insane, and you're only gonna make her worse, so... And she has a kind of weird love-hate thing with, like, mother figures.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, that's another thing about her. Like, if you're a female master, she will insist on calling you mom.
Don't tell her no.
Yeah, don't tell her no. Yeah. And the only other skill, surgical procedure, that actually has like one of the lowest ranks possible, E.
That's fair. Reading an enemy info.
Good. Like the second one, or have other ones popped up since then?
I'm pretty sure that's the second one.
Okay. So, what surgical procedure is that it's like you said, you know, that Jack the Ripper has kind of been thought to be a surgeon of some sort because of the way he was able to cut up his victims, right?
Right, specifically, like, designating certain organs to go in certain areas in the last one. Putting everything very specifically.
So, the way that that's
true. I snuck up on you!
Oh, yeah. At some point, when you're a high enough level, the enemies will just ignore you. They'll never run away, but they certainly don't want to start anything with you. So, with this low rank of a skill procedure, she's actually able to, like, heal minor wounds and stuff. Although, I guess it really depends on what one considers minor wounds.
Right.
Because this one person, like, her master got stabbed, and she was able to sew that back up. Thing is, though, like, she's described as using techniques that's over 120 years old, so it looks shoddy and really back alley-like.
Oh, that's where she grew.
Yeah. But, you know, because...
Cannon fodder such as this presents no challenge.
So, because she's, using a more or less magically granted skill associated with her person, it's actually better than it seems. Like, the person who got stabbed, she was able to completely stop the bleeding, and there was no pain coming from the wound. It just looked like that someone haphazardly, like, sewed up a string along them. And then, oh yeah, like, she
Hugh
was...
Hugh Clementine sewing her own arm up.
And that one person who, like, she cut off the arm of and even the lower jaw of, like, she was able to stop their bleeding and keep them perfectly alive using her surgical procedure.
Oh boy.
Yep. So if like you ever get hurt, or if you ever want to keep certain people alive for whatever reason, yeah, she can help out with that.
As long as they're minor wounds, like a jaw being missing.
Yes.
At most minor wound. That's a minor wound? That's a D? You said it was a D rank?
No, E rank.
Oh god.
Yeah, E rank.
Imagine if it was better. Imagine an A rank. It's like, yo, I'm just a brain in a jar. Keep you alive.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Oh man, BlackJACK from anime as a servant.
Oh god. I think his surgical rank
S plus.
Like S plus plus plus. Like the hot
surgery.
No,
ghosts.
No, it would just be EX. just straight up EX.
It's what he's known for. It's the one of the only things he's known for. He once performed surgery on a ghost and a computer and a plant. Screw it, he'll heal anything. Yeah. Oh, that's awesome. Oh god, it's even more annoying now that they don't come at me.
Okay, so the last thing to cover about Loli Rippa would be, you know,
the combination of the best things possible for her?
No, her noble phantasms.
Ah, yes.
You know, the embodiment of a heroic spirit's legend. They're
Jack the Ripper is my hero. I read about him when I was a kid. I was like, that's my idol. One day I too will be in Victorian era British town, back alley slaughtering prostitutes. I can't wait. Level 5 is where I'm headed though. I think we're done with leveling up for now. I ain't gonna get any higher levels with this low level.
You might. No. Plus, I ain't done talking about Loli Rippa.
Fine. I guess I can't go through dialogue now.
Well, normally, when I go through this, I always try to go up to level 4, at least.
I'm 5.
Yeah, so this actually helps you out in the long run.
I guess. You were a caster, so that says something.
Oh, actually, I think as a caster, I went all the way up to level 7.
Oh, fair enough.
Because, like, I was a caster. Also, I was playing on normal.
Okay, so go ahead.
Okay, so she comes with two noble phantasms.
Oh boy.
Which is actually, this is kind of like the norm, apparently. Like, servants will usually come with multiple noble phantasms.
Oh, I thought it was supposed to be one.
Yeah, but in this version of the Holy Grail War, it is only one noble phantasm. And in certain other iterations, they only get one noble phantasm. But like, in a normal Holy Grail War, they can have multiple noble phantasms.
Yeah.
So, Assassin Jack, as two noble phantasms, are the Mist, which is a rank C, and Maria the Ripper, which actually can be anywhere from a rank D to a rank B.
Those are still not very, like, high.
Yeah, well, the thing is that noble phantasms are kind of like in a league of their own. Like, it's... Like, there's something somewhere out there that shows off on a chart of how a noble phantasm of rank C is, like, comparable to a rank A of a normal skill of some sort.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. So even low rank, you know, a noble phantasm is going to be good at what it does. So, I'll talk about the Mist first.
The Mist!
Yep. The Mist comes in the form of like this little lantern with a candle in it. What she does is that she opens the lantern, strokes the candle, and then like a mist will come out from it.
Bring in any info.
Interesting. And
one after another they come. Will they ever learn?
Yeah. And she's able to perfectly control this mist.
Perfectly.
Yep, it's classified as a barrier of sorts, and honestly, it almost seems like a pseudo-reality marble. Yep, so with this mist, she can set it up within so many feet around her, able to create blank patches to where no one is affected, or just able to completely blanket the area. It's supposed to be a representation of the London fogs in the past. You know, due to, like, Industrial Revolution and how badly that got.
Right.
Mm-hmm. So, this mist, what it does is that it upon contact with human skin, like it will cause blisters, extreme pain, and it will just basically choke the person out within like a few minutes.
And, man, that Industrial Revolution was some crazy shit.
They had some bad fog. Like,
that's not fog, that's something beyond. Oh, wow, how'd you live? Like, what are you? What kind of monster are you?
But yeah, like, it would basically just kill, like, a normal person who stayed in there for a few minutes.
Right.
And, for, like, a magical person user, they could actually survive for, like, a good couple more minutes. You know, before it just utterly destroyed them. And for servants, it makes their, agility go down a rank, if I remember correctly.
Doesn't even hurt them.
Yeah, it doesn't even hurt them. Just makes their agility go down. So, one thing that, she can do is that she can summon this mist and manipulate it to where her master could be nearby, but she would be, like, in a safe space, if you will.
Uh-huh.
While everyone else just gets, like, badly poisoned and killed off that's, human. Oh, and this mist also has a secondary effect. Whenever someone is in it, they can't, like, find their way. Like, I'm trying to remember if there's, like, a term or something for it.
Lost? Wander the mist?
I don't know, it's like, you know how if you're going through the forest and you don't have a destination in mind, you'll just wander around in circles? Like, is there a name for that? Disorient? Is that what I'm looking for?
Oh, yes.
Alright, so yeah, this mist will, like, disorient your direction. To where you could be in a very small room and there's one door, and the moment this mist comes out, if you try to run for that door, you'll never reach it. Because that's just how magical the nature of this mist is.
Huh.
So, once you're stuck in it, you're stuck in it. Unless you're either a servant or
your servant helps you out.
Yeah, or like you're a magus. Like, if you're a magus, you might be able to find a way to get yourself out by, really? Like, you know, casting a magical spell of some sort, possibly to, like, disperse the mist or try to find a way out.
You know, right.
So there's actually a chance if you're a magus. For humans, you're screwed. You're just give up on life. The mist has you now.
What if you dig down? How do you get lost going down?
Well,
I mean, I guess it's not, you know,
thing
Minecraft.
Is, like, this mist, it kind of kills you within, like, a few minutes. And even before then, a few minutes earlier, it already, like, incapacitated you with pain alone.
Now I'm just imagining if you tried to fire a submachine gun in all directions. Like, trying to hit the master. Like, if you kill the master, how truly pathetic I demand further entertainment!
Yeah, if that happened and that master deserved it.
For being out in the mist with that special secret patch?
Yeah, for basically being so close that someone just basically blind fired and managed to hit you. Why, as the master, are you not just, like, if you're even there, me, I would be waiting home. Be like, okay, Jack, go here, take care of that.
Yeah, obviously. Well, as a master of any servant, I'd be practically doing that.
Yeah, it's just
anywhere.
Like, you know, it's just that, like, you know, Loli Rippa's built for that. You know, pretty much undetectable, will always get the first strike. And, like, this is if you're at night and stuff like that. And, you know, has an all-encompassing fog.
Okay,
like,
ahead.
You know. But, yeah, if you just end up getting hit by blind fire, you deserve it. So, that's the mist.
She'll fix it with her surgery.
Actually, yeah, she probably could fix it with her surgery.
Unless you die.
Yeah.
Headshots and all.
Right.
Anyway.
So then there's her other noble phantasm. Like, her grand master ability, if you will.
Mm-hmm.
Maria the Ripper. What this is, it is a simple curse that... And hang on, I want to make sure I say this correctly because I thought, well, that's just wonderful. Okay. Normally 4 D rank knives, but under certain conditions, they are, and this is quoted, boosted by the grudge of the 80,000 children in London slums abandoned by prostitute mothers for the sake of their livelihoods unable to even become prostitutes themselves.
Well, it sounds like they weren't trying hard enough. Not with an attitude like that, quitters.
Okay. So.
That's like, you know, when I was their age, when I was birthed straight out the womb, I made passes at the doctor. They weren't, get on my freaking level. I don't know, man, never has there been a joke done in such poor taste as thumbing your nose at the freaking, at biting your thumb at the freaking orphans that died in the slums of Britain.
Yeah, who died to the great smog.
Ah, yes, the great smog.
You know, that thing that killed over, like, 10,000 to 100,000 people. I forget the numbers.
That killed people?
Oh, yeah. In London, the Great Smog got so bad that, like, people died in the thousands.
What?
Because, you know, it was filled with all the sulfuric acid and stuff from Industrial Revolution that was thrown up into the sky.
How in the shit did people not die from the China smog that's been going on?
They probably have been doing, but, you know, I'm not all that interested. Unless some, like, you know, a resurgence of Jack the Virgin rises in China.
It's Captain Planet-based Jack the Ripper. He's doing it for environmental reasons.
Okay, so these D-ranked knives actually go up in, like, a level. And their move is more or less a curse. So, what happens is that under certain conditions, the move gets stronger.
Yep.
Like, I believe that as it is, just by itself, you're just basically slashing at someone with some knives.
But, four of them.
Yeah, four knives. And like, the more conditions that are fulfilled, the more damage that they do.
Right.
But, you know, under the right conditions, this move can one-shot anybody.
The enemy info.
Even servants. I mean,
does that include not actual living beings? Like what? A building?
Oh, no. Because that wouldn't fulfill one of the criteria.
Oh, right. It can't be a female building.
Right. Okay, so the conditions are, it must be night, it must be misty, and the target must be female. As long as, like, those three conditions are fulfilled, you know, Jack the Ripper the Assassin can one-shot whoever the target is, which means that, you know, your saber right there could just easily be one-shotted.
Huh.
Yep. So, like, if you were in the Holy Grail War, and it was nighttime,
and
a mysterious mist just appeared around Saber, she's as good as dead.
Well, I mean, there's some mitigating factors like luck and stuff, right?
Luck is only a factor when it's daytime.
Really?
Uh-huh. Oh, right. I should describe what exactly happens.
Okay.
Okay, so, like, when she uses the move and all the conditions are not fulfilled, it's just a really strong knife attack. But when the conditions are fulfilled, the curse changes the target into, like, a dismembered corpse. Like, in one moment, Saber's there. But in another moment...
She's on the ground, dismembered.
Yeah, she's underground, like, guts just spewed out from her body. Knives, like, you know, probably everywhere. And it's just, she's dead.
Horrifying.
She's gone. Yeah, it's over.
That's horrifying.
Yep, this is described not so much as a move, but so much as it is a curse.
That's... So, reality bending.
Actually, yes, it is pretty much reality bending.
Question. Because,
yes.
What if the person could survive that? Or, you know, heal from it? Like, you know, oh yeah, I'm dismembered, but I could get better. Like, you know, what if it happened to BlackJack and he just sewed himself back up, if BlackJack were a woman?
Huh.
He's performed self-surgery before, it's not out of the question. He's survived being... Oh, wow, this is gonna be the first time I've had... Oh, man, this is only gonna have to be the third time I've had to, you know, perform surgery with no arms, no legs, and while being completely, you know, splayed open.
Yeah, with, like, my intestines and heart just spewed out on the ground.
Pulls out a scalpel with teeth.
Actually, like, I'm just kind of imagining he turns his head and, like, grabs a scalpel with his tongue. Well, time to get to work.
Not again.
Yeah, but
another day of the life of BlackJack.
I'm actually not sure in that kind of case. I don't know of any female servant out there
that strong, huh?
Yeah, they would be able to survive a literal reality curse warping dismemberment in an instant. Yeah, and that I think essentially is like that is the grandioseness of what it is of just upgrading an assassin. Jack the Ripper is near nigh undetectable. Even when you do detect her, it's too late because she probably already has the first attack. Because any smart master would have her just be attacking at night, to where she's guaranteed that advantage. And since it's night and she probably already preempted the mist, then she's gonna have like a really strong lead in whatever she does. And if you're a woman, forget about it, you're already dead. Although, now that I think about it, there is actually one servant I know of that is able to counter this move.
Uh-huh. Oh, is it Nobunaga?
Yes, actually it is Nobunaga.
Because, something about her being strong against legends and myths and stuff.
Right, since Nobunaga went on that church-burning crusade during her time, because Nobunaga's a woman in Fate, of course,
yes,
that she has like advantages against any mysteries and stuff like that. And since Jack the Ripper's legacy is born off of a mystery, that means that she would actually have an advantage against everything that Jack the Ripper did.
Even like preemptive strikes, right?
Right. Even preemptive strikes.
Wait, but the preemptive strikes makes sense though, like without any mystery behind them really, she was a little girl.
Right. But, you know, just, like, everything about Jack the Ripper in general, Nobunaga would have an advantage against, because it's all rooted in mystery and legends and all that kind of stuff.
Right.
So, yeah, she's, like, one of those few that would probably be, like, a pretty good counter. Still, anyone else, I'd say that they're screwed. Okay, so, like, I'd say we've shown off pretty good what it's like to...
Actually, I think I know one other person who might be able to survive it. Medusa.
I seriously doubt that, but why do you say that?
Well, anything she looks at is turned to stone, right?
Yes.
So if she was to in the fog and she just pulled off her blindfold and started looking in every direction, then at some point she's going to hit Loli Jack the Ripper, and she'll turn to stone.
That might only work in one condition, mm-hmm. and if that is if she backed herself into a corner, like a really tight corner, and just looked forward. Hopefully, Loli Rippa would not be above you and would be in a peripheral vision. Thing is, though, with how the mist works, unless she was particularly lucky or did something in particular, I doubt she would be able to find a corner in time.
Well, I mean, what's wrong with looking in every, just spinning and looking in every direction?
It takes time for stuff to freeze over.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, she's only actually... kind of slightly... crossed over.
Yeah, she has to like have her gaze on it in order for it to take effect.
Oh.
But thing is, by that time she's already dead.
Yeah, fair enough.
Okay, so that was my symposium on Jack the Ripper the Assassin. Oh, there was some other stuff I wanted to say, but this has gone on long enough.
Yep.
Okay. And we showed off what grinding is like in this game.
Oh boy.
Probably won't be doing this again in the future unless like there's some other servant that I really want to talk about.
Keep this entertaining. You're probably gonna have to put up a lot of example pictures or something.
You think I didn't already plan for that?
No,
in
I'm
fact,
cheating.
Future Ada, put up another picture right now. Alright. So. So, yeah. Like, Tsuyoi has made some good progress. Like, you're actually really got close to leveling up again.
I probably will off camera.
Okay, so, like, Tsuyoi will get that one extra level. And then we'll pick up our recordings and also get to start talking about the reason that Loli Rippa was brought up in the first place in the next episode.
See ya.